Okay, previously I was explaining this problem. In this problem, interest on tax-free debenture is there. If the tax-free debenture is there, you have to compulsorily gross up. You gross up that tax-free debenture, compulsory gross up. Okay. And less tax and other debentures, interest issued is there, you gross up. And second point is interest on 16% debentures. Interest on 16% debentures. Rupees 1 lakh. It indicates that 1 lakh is interest. But in the problem, there is a mistake. You consider that interest on 1 lakh 16% debentures. You bring this 1 lakh rupee first year. Here you write 1 lakh. If that 1 lakh you record here, interest on 1 lakh rupee. Interest on 1 lakh rupee, 16% debentures of Kirloskar Limited. So you cancel here and take here. Then it is, the sentence is correct. Okay. So you calculate 16% interest on Kirloskar Limited. Interest received on government security is there. Received is there, but government security interest will not be grossed up. Okay. Government securities will not be grossed up. Winning from lottery net is here. Net interest, net winning is there. So you gross up that. Okay. Then example, next point is, rupees 1000 paid for purchase of lottery ticket. So expense related with casual incomes, are not allowed. Remember this. Casual income samband pattirthakanta expense yavu allow agudilla matte yare 1000 purchase hakkirare. Then 200 rupees paid for collection charges of interest. This is allowable. 200 you give allowable under section 57. So you see the solution. First, I'll take tax-free debenture. Tax-free debenture is interest is 27,000. 27,000 into 100 by 90. Because it is tax rate for the interest on investment is 10%. Remember this. Tax rate of interest on investment is 10%. After deducting 10% tax portion, the company gives interest to the investor. Therefore, to make it gross off, you multiply by 100 and divide by 90. Sarena nimtor. Casual income ka tax rate 30% irodrinda 30% ke cut maadi 70% kottirtaru aduk divided by 70 bartadu. In your interest golige tax rate 10% irodrinda 10% cut maadi 90% kottirtaru aduk divided by 90 bartadu. Okay, so 27,000 into 100 by 90 is equal to 30,000. Then second is interest on 16% debenture. Interest on 16% debenture, 1 lakh into 16 by 100 is equal to 16,000. Then third is interest on government security. Interest on government security. interest on government security is amount is 12,000. You take directly 12,000 rupee. Then winning from lottery is there 70,000 rupee. Net is there, you gross up. Winning from lottery 70,000 into 100 by 70. Rate of tax is 30%. Therefore, you take divide by 70. That is 1 lakh. These are the incomes. You take the total. Total is 1,58,000. In that 1,58,000 gross income, you deduct deduction under section 57. Deduction under section 57 is collection charges on interest. Collection charges on interest. You deduct it. Then whatever balance comes, that is the income from other source. Income from other source. Okay. And I'll explain the remaining problems here. You see the okay, you see the next problem. In the next problem, the following are the details relating to Mr. Naveen for the previous year ending 31st March 2020. Income from agriculture in Nepal. Income from agriculture in Nepal. The first point, agriculture income in Nepal. Okay, is it taxable or not? Agriculture income, taxable or exempted? The agriculture income is taxable because it is outside India. So first point is 10,000. First point is 10,000 is taxable. Second point, interest on post office saving bank. It is exempted under section 10. POSB account interest is exempted. Then third is dividend from India, foreign company. Dividend from Indian company is exempted and foreign company, this is taxable. This is taxable. Foreign company is taxable, but not gross up because the tax deducted may be relating to foreign country, not to the Indian government. Therefore, it should not be grossed up. Dividend from foreign company is taxable. Interest on bank deposit is taxable. Okay. Then interest on subletting of house. Rent from subletting of house is 26,250. And Nisha paid rent, paid rent by Nisha for subletted house is 12,000. So income is 26,250. Allowable expenses relating to house is 12,000 is one, another other expense related to sublet out is 1,000. Total expense is 13,000. You deduct 13,000 balances. I think it is 13,250. Is it or not? This is the answer. First point is taxable. Second point is exempt. Third point is taxable, fourth is taxable, fifth is taxable. And for the fifth point, there are two deductions. What is the answer? Yes, Tagi Thiyod. First point, calculate the math, they are murder. You calculate in your calculator. First point, 10,003. Second point, exempt bit. Third point, 700. Fourth point, 5,000. fourth point 5000 taka yet amount aitu. What is the income up to fourth point?
$15,700
is the total. Okay. Then you take this 26,250 in the inner column. You take 26,250 in the inner column and deduct these two. 13,000 deduction under section 57. Money ಬಾಡಿಗೆ ತಗೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಆ ಬಾಡಿಗೆಗೆ ಸಂಬಂಧಪಟ್ಟದ್ದು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪೆನ್ಸ್ ಎರಡು ಅದಾವ 13,000 ಕಳೆದ್ರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ 13,250 ಉಳಿತೈತಿ ಯು ಆಡ್ 13,250 ವಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಇ ಈಸ್ 13,250 15,700 ಪ್ಲಸ್ 13,250 28,950 28,950 is the answer. Clear? One particular column, more amount column. First amount directly to the outer column. C point direct outer column. D point direct outer column. E point you write in the middle column. Write the deduction in the inner column. Deduct them and take the ultimate answer to the outer column. You will get 28,950 answer. Clear? Come to the next problem. Mr. Gururaj has furnished the following details of his income for the previous year 1920. Rupees 40,000 per month salary as member of parliament. Member of parliament salary is the salary taxable under the head other source. Okay. He is not a employee. Therefore comes under other source. Il one doubt any tanta kedra per month kottida idu annual tagobeku per month tagobeku yaru obru helu per month salary is there. I am in doubt. Tingli 40,000 rupai pagar ite per month per PM means what? Whether that is prime minister or per month. I am doubt regarding that. PM 40,000 PM. If you consider that as a prime minister, then 40,000 only you take. If you consider that as a per month, you take 40,000 per month. Clear? Any doubt? PM capital, P capital, capital P capital M. What it mean? Is it per month or prime minister?
Prime Minister.
If you say is Prime Minister, then 40,000 is the salary. Okay. If you consider that per month, you take 40,000 into 12. Clear? First point. So you consider this as a Prime Minister and take 40,000. Income from agriculture land in Japan, is it taxable or not? Income from agriculture land in Japan.
Taxable.
Taxable second item. It is taxable. Then next is dividend on shares of foreign company. Dividend on shares of foreign company. Is taxable or not?
Taxable.
Taxable. Indian company dividend is exempted. Indian company dividend is exempted. then dividend of 40,000 on shares of ACC Limited. ACC company, is it a Indian company or foreign company? Anyone tell me? Yes. ACC company, India to foreign to? Associate Cement Company. There is a group of company. Remember, ACC is an Indian company. It is an Indian company exempted from tax. This is exempted from tax. Dividend from Indian company is exempted. Next, ground rent, 40,000. This comes under other source. Then winning from lottery. Winning from lottery is here, 10,500, but it is net. You have to gross up. What is the gross amount of winning from lottery? Gross amount of winning from lottery. What is the gross amount? 10,500 is the net. You make it gross and tell me what is the answer.
Fifteen thousand
is the answer. Okay, this is $15,000. Then last is received $12,000 as director fee. Director fee is taxable. This is taxable. Can anyone take the total and tell me what is the answer? First point, 40,000. Second point, 38,000. Third point, 25,000. Fourth point, exempted. Fifth point, 40,000. Sixth point, 15,000. Last point, 12,000. What is the total? Yes. First point
70,000.
First point 40,000. First point you take 40,000 as a that is Prime Minister. PM means Prime Minister. Remember that. Small PM consider as per month. If it is capital, you consider as a Prime Minister. You take 40,000. 40 plus 38, 78. 78 plus 25 over. 78 plus 25 over 1,03,000. 1,03,000 plus 40,000. 1,43,000, I think. 1,43,000 plus 15,000 plus 12,000. What is the answer? 1,70,000. 1,70,000 is the answer. Simple answer is there. This is 5 marks question. Then you see the next example, the investments of Mr. Rajesh. investments of Mr. Rajesh for the year ending 31st March 2020 consist the following. Investments are given for you people, not the interest. Remember the wording. Wording given in the heading. Wording given in the heading is investments. Means whatever investments made by Mr. Rajesh are given for you people, then you calculate interest. Okay, you have to calculate interest on those. ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೊಟ್ಟದ್ದು ಏನು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ನೀವು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು. ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಗಿವನ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ದಿ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್. 50,000 7% ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟಿ. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ 7% ಆನ್ 50,000? 7% on 50,000.
3,500.
3,000. This is 3,500. Okay.
500.
And then second, come to second. 15,000 6% securities of foreign government. 15,000 is the amount. Rate of interest is 6%. What is the 6% on 15,000 investment?
900.
Second point is 900. Then come to the third point. 20,000 8% municipal bonds. In the municipal bonds, he invested 20,000. Rate of interest is 8%. What is the interest?
1,600.
600. Next is 15% 7 year national savings certificate 8th issue. This is exempted from tax. This is exempted from tax. The next is 20,000 9% municipal trust bonds. 20,000 is invested in 9% municipal bonds.
1,800.
This is 1,800. 1,800. Then come to the next. 7% of national plan certificate. 7% of national plan certificate is exempted from tax. Okay. Then he paid commission 60 rupees on collection of interest on security. And also paid 1,200 as interest on bank loan taken for the purpose of purchasing municipal port trust bond. Municipal port trust bond. Okay. Municipal port trust bond. Municipal port trust bond is taxable or exempted? Municipal port trust bonds are example like 8. Adun taxable until kun tokondero, yen exempted bitidero. Sorry, poor trust bonds. Poor trust bonds is there. It is taxable. Taxable means it is allowed. So 60 rupee and 1,200 are allowable expenses. Then take the total of this. What is the total of the taxable income? 3,500 plus 900 plus 1,600 plus 1,800.
$7,800.
In the 7,800, you deduct 1,260 allowable expense under section 57. 7,800 minus 1,200. What is the answer?
6,540.
Clear? 6,540. That is the answer. Now you see the example based on 16 marks. I already solved five marks questions. and dictated 16 exam to 16. Then remaining four are there. You go through them. Otherwise, I'll dictate them and you solve them. Sorry, I need to worry. If none either question, but see any 5 marks do I example now? But see any would do here in a I example and to margin in would do explain margin on bursary. Ega 15 marks question in number 10. Now I come to the 15 marks question. First question based on 15 marks is Johnny furnishes the following particulars of his investment. You see the wording, what is there? Word is investments is there. You have to see it. Investment kotida nimage interest kotida antu helilla investment kotida andre interest calculate madbek okay investments are given for you people then you tell me what is the interest on 20,007% government security 20,000 is the investment 7% is the interest rate of interest what is the amount
1400
okay then 30,000 tax free 30,000 is the investment 30,000 is the investment rate of interest is 18% rate of interest is 18% but the debentures are tax free first you tell me what is the interest $30,000 into 18%.
$5,400
is the interest, tax-free interest. Okay, the tax-free is there. Therefore, you have to gross up. You have to gross up. That is 5,400 into 100/90. 100/90. What is the gross interest?
6,000.
ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ನೆನಪಿಟ್ಟುಕೋರಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾದ್ರೆ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಗ್ರಾಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕು ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರೀ ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ರೆ ಯಾವಾಗಲೂ ಗ್ರಾಸ್ ಅಪ್ ಮಾಡೋದನ್ನ ಓಕೆ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ 6,000 ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ 6,000 ದೆನ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಯು ಥರ್ಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ 1 lakh rupee 10% ಡಿಬೆಂಚರ್ಸ್ 1 lakh rupee ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಇನ್ವೆಸ್ಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ 10% is the rate of interest. What is the amount of interest? Yes, come on, tell
10,000.
Me. 1 lakh investment, rate is 10%. What is the interest?
10,000
is interest. Okay. 10,000 is interest. Come to the next point. 40,000 is investment. In 10% debentures of Y Limited. Investment is 40,000. Rate of interest is 10%. What is the interest?
4,000.
Okay. Next 50,000 is the investment. 50,000 is the investment. 8% is the rate of interest, municipal debentures. What is the interest?
4,000.
Next point, 40,000 is the investment, 15% is the rate. What is the interest?
6,000.
Amount is? Interest is
6,000.
Okay. Clear. Then they state that interest is payable on the above securities on 30th June and 31st December. Annually, the interest is payable on 30th June and 31st December every year. Two times they give the interest. Two times they give the interest means half of the interest is paid at the end of half period, remaining half interest is paid at the second half of the period. Remember this. ಮತ್ತೆ ಯಾರು ಎರಡ್ ಸಲ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರ ಅಂತಕೊಂಡು ಎರಡ್ ಸಲ ಗುಣಕಾರ ಮಾಡಿ ಇಟ್ಟಿರಿ, ಆರ್ ತಿಂಗಳಿಗೆ ಅರ್ಧ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೋ ಇನ್ನ ಅರ್ಧ ಆರ್ ತಿಂಗಳಾಗ ಕೊಡ್ತಾರೆ, ಇದ್ರ ಅರ್ಧ. ಅಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಮಿಡಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇಯರ್. ಇಫ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟೀಸ್ ಆರ್ ಸೋಲ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಮಿಡಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಇಯರ್, ದೆನ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಕನ್ಸಿಡರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಇಂಟರೆಸ್ಟ್. ವರ್ಷದ ನಡುವಟ್ಟೆ ಮಾರಿದ್ರೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಈ ಲೆಕ್ಕಕ್ಕೆ ತಗೋಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಟೀಟಾ then bank charge 1% commission on collection charges. Bank charges are 1% commission, bank commission is 1% on collection as collection charge on the net interest. This is important. Sriya notation yen hetta 1% commission tokutaru bank now yetra mel tokutaru ನೆಟ್ ಇಂಟರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ ಖಾತೆಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಬಂದಿರ್ತೈತಿ ಅದ್ರ ಮೇಲೆ, ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಆನ್ ದಿ ಆನ್ ದಟ್ ಇಂಟರೆಸ್ಟ್ 1% ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕರ್. ಓಕೆ, 1% ನೀವು ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮೇಲೆ ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ರಿ ಅಂತ, 1% ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಬ್ಯಾಂಕರ್ಸ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಆನ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್. This is the point you remember. ಈಗ ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ ಇದನ್ನ ಏನಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರ, ಈಗ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಕೊಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಿಮಗೆ. 20,000 ಇನ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್, 20,000 ಇಸ್ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, 7% ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಸೆಕ್ಯೂರಿಟೀಸ್, 1,400 ಇಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಇಂಟ್ರೆಸ್ಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗ್ತದ. ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್ 1% ಬ್ಯಾಂಕರ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದಿ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಚಾರ್ಜ್. ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್, 1% banker takes because 1,400 rupee check is there. 1,400 rupee check is there and banker takes 1% for collection of this check. It is clear. Tax is not deducted. Come to the second point. 6,000 is your interest. Second point, you make the clear. 6,000 is the interest, but 6,000 is not paid by X company to you people. Remember. After deduction of tax on this, remaining amount is paid to you people as net. As net, remember this. Andre inka calculate madidre nodri rest agutte 6000 nivu pura barudilla, 6000 interest calculate madidre nivu. Eradne point ige 6000 interest calculate madidre kare 6000 kudulla avru nivu. 6000 daga tax cut madi kudtaru. Idrage 10% tax iddi, ellalku 10% tax iruttati. ಆದ್ರೆ ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಅವ್ರು ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದೀನಿ ನಾನು. ಈ 6,000 10% ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ 600 ರೂಪಾಯಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ. 600 ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಕಟ್ ಮಾಡಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಿಕ್ತೈತಿ ಇದ್ರಾಗ ನೆಟ್? ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್, ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ 6,000 600 ಇಸ್ ದಿ ಟ್ಯಾಕ್ಸ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ದೇ ಡಿಡಕ್ಟ್, ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಟು ಯು ಪೀಪಲ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿ ಚೆಕ್ ರಿಸೀವ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಯು ಪೀಪಲ್ ಆನ್ ದಿಸ್